This video is going to be about finding the quadratic equation when you're given the roots of the equation and a point. So here's what this is about. Let's say I've got this graph. This graph is a downward opening parabola. It goes through the horizontal axis, the x-axis, at the point where x equals 2 and x equals 5. So what we know is that there are two roots to the equation, and the roots are 2 and 5. It also goes through the vertical axis, the y-axis, at the place where y equals negative 2. Okay, so I can take those two roots. I can write x equals 2 and 5. And as I've done in a previous video, I can rewrite them as x equals 2 and x equals 5. And then I can set both of those equations to 0. I can have x minus 2 equals 0, and x minus 5 equals 0. And then since both of the equations are equal to 0, I'm just going to multiply them together. So I've got x minus 2 times x minus 5 equals 0. And now I'm just going to change its form to y equals x minus 2 times x minus 5. Now I could multiply these out, the x minus 2 and the x minus 5, but I'm not ready for that yet. Here's the next thing I've got to think about. I've got that third point there, 0 comma negative 2, and I haven't accounted for that. So here's what I'm getting at. Let's look at this pair of axes. So I've got an x and y axis, and on the x-axis I'm going to mark the points where x equals 2 and where x equals 5. And I could draw a parabola that goes through those two points. I could draw a parabola like this. And that parabola would have the solutions x equals 2 and 5. But I could have drawn a totally different parabola. I could have drawn an upward opening parabola that also went through those two points. And that would have the same solutions, x equals 2 and 5. I could have drawn a third parabola, a very steep downward opening parabola that goes through 2 and 5 on the x-axis. And that would have the same solution. But I want an equation for a specific parabola. I want the equation for the parabola that I was given. And this parabola goes through the point 0, comma, negative 2. So here's what I've got to do. I've got to realize at that point, 0, comma, negative 2 is a coordinate pair. It's an ordered pair. So I can think of the first part as the x and the second part as the y. And now let's look at the equation I have so far. Well, you know, if this equation, let's think about it. When I multiply this out, I'm going to get, if I multiply it just like this, I'm going to get an x squared. But it's a downward opening parabola. So if it's a downward opening parabola, I want the coefficient of the x squared to be negative. So it seems like I would have to multiply this whole equation by something, or multiply, I'm sorry, the right side by something to make the x squared negative. Okay, well, here's how we find what the something is. Let's say that the something, I'm going to call that a. Some books are going to call it A, some books are going to call it K. It doesn't really matter what you call it. You can't call it X or Y because we've used those two letters already. I want to find out what I'm multiplying X minus 2 times X minus 5 by so that I'm going to get a negative coefficient, and it's going to have to be a very specific negative coefficient. Okay, I know that I've got this point at 0, comma, negative 2, so I can think of, at that point, X equals 0 and Y equals negative 2. So anytime I've got a coordinate pair, an ordered pair, all I have to do is take that pair and plug them in where I've got x's and y's. So I'm going to take the y equals negative 2. I'm going to replace the y with a negative 2. I still have this a. And then instead of x, I'm going to have 0. So I'll have 0 minus 2 times 0 minus 5 And now all I've got to do is multiply this all out and find out what A equals. Okay, so negative 2 equals A times, well, 0 minus 2 is negative 2, and 0 minus 5 is negative 5. So all I'm doing is multiplying negative 2 times negative 5, and that's going to be a positive 10. So negative 2 equals A times 10, or 10A. And I'll divide both sides by 10. So I'm going to have negative 2 over 10 equals A, and I'll reduce that negative 2 over 10. So that's going to just be negative 1/5. Negative 1/5 is A. Okay? And then I can go back where I've got this A, and instead of the A, I'm going to have negative 1/5. Okay, so this is going to be the specific equation, y equals negative 1/5 times x minus 2 times x minus 5. It's going to be the specific equation that gives me that specific graph. Let me go over this again. Okay, we're given this graph. From that graph, I find out what the solutions are. I can find that just by looking at the graph. Okay, I take those solutions, I set them both, I set x equal to each one of the solutions, then I take my equations, set the equations equal to 0, and then I'm going to write out y equals, in this case, something like x minus 2 times x minus 5. But I've got to find out what's multiplying the right side of the equation to give me the specific graph. Okay, so I'm going to call the thing that's multiplying it A or K or any letter I want, just about. Then I'm going to go back and find a third point. In this case, I've got a point which is actually right on the graph, right on the y-axis. It could have been any third point. Okay? I take the x and y values from that third point and plug them in where my x and y values were in the solution I'd gotten to so far. And then I solve that for A. Once I know what A is, I take the A and I plug it back in where I had the A. So I get y equals whatever the A was times the two binomials, x minus 2 and x minus 5. And then if I want to, I could, of course, multiply x minus 2 times x minus 5 and get something with an x squared. And if I wanted to go even further, I could multiply everything by negative 5. That's just a question of finding out what form you're supposed to put the final answer into. Okay, so that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.